Hello, this is Professor Zaman. Welcome to Hasan Zaman educational video series. In this video, we will discuss voltage source and current source. In electrical circuits, sometimes you need to convert a voltage source to a current source or a current source to a voltage source to be able to solve a circuit. So when you convert, you create an equivalent source. If you go from voltage source to current source or current source to voltage source. So let's look at that. So let's first look at voltage source to current source. Suppose we have a voltage source of 100 volt with resistance. So E is equal to 100 volt and series resistance, say 1 ohm. So you can convert this to a current source. Only difference will be this series resistance will become a parallel resistance. We call this RP, and that will be same as RS, which is 1 ohm. And this value of this is ES, and this value of IS will be given by ES over RS, which is 100 volt over 1 ohm equal to 100 ampere. To make it different, let's make it 2 ohm. So it will be 2 ohm ampere. So these sources will be treated as equivalent sources. From outside, if you connect anything, you will see the outside currents and voltage will remain the same, no change, there will be no change. But inside the source, they are not equivalent. For example, this current here on this parallel resistor is not the current here. But outside, if you look from the terminal, they will behave like the same source. If you have a current source, say 100 ampere, and it has a parallel resistor of RP equal to 20 ohm, you can convert it to a voltage source of value this RP will be, RS will be same as RP, 20 ohm, and the voltage source value, ES will be same as, this is IS, IS times RP, 100 ampere times 20 ohm. 2000 volt. Resistance remains the same between the conversion. It is 2 ohm here, also 2 ohm here. It is 20 ohm here, 20 ohm here. Only the voltage source value will be changed to a current source value, and which you get by dividing this voltage source by this resistance. It will be 50 ampere here. And in this case, if you multiply this current times the resistance, and you get the voltage source value. So this conversion is sometimes useful in solving circuits. So we'll do a simple example to find the effectiveness of this technique. Load resistance, say 50 ohm. So we need to find out the current through the load. How do you solve this circuit? We can use the techniques we have learned, like branch current or mesh current or nodal analysis, to find this current. But we can find this current actually in a simpler way by just doing a source conversion. So in this case, if we convert this current source into a voltage source, it will become just one loop and it will be easy to solve. So let's do that. So we'll convert this current source into a voltage source. So we're converting this part into a voltage source. The resistance value remains same, 5 ohm. And the voltage source value becomes this current times this resistance, 4 times 5, 20 volt. And this part remains the same. So this is RL, 50 ohm, this current IL, we have to find. Now this same current is flowing along the whole circuit because there is just one loop. And voltage drop polarities are minus plus, and here current is flowing upward, so plus here, minus here. It will be dropping upward and then dropping downward. Okay. So if you write the KVL equation, it's 20 minus 5 IL, this is 10 volt, plus 10 minus 50 IL is equal to 0. Come back to the ground node. So IL will be 20 plus 10 divided by 5 plus 50.55 ampere. So we have solved this seemingly difficult circuit easily by converting this current source into a voltage source. So this technique can be useful. Sometimes we have to go the other way around, that is converting a voltage source into a current source can help solve a circuit. Now we will look at an example where converting a voltage source to a current source can make it easier to solve a circuit. So let's draw the circuit. So we have a current source 4 ohm. We have a load resistance 2 ohm. And we need to find the load current IL. So this can be solved in many ways, but we will use source conversion method. We'll convert this voltage source into a current source and solve it. So 8 volt and 4 ohm. So we can replace this with a current source 4 ohm, and this current source value will be 8 volt over 4 ohm, 2 ampere. Now we can redraw the circuit because this is the same node, so we will not touch this resistance, this load resistance, so we'll have to keep it to find the current here. But we will redraw this part. This is the same node, so we'll draw this source, current source here, 4 ampere. Next to it, we'll draw this current source, 2 ampere. Then we'll draw the 4 ohm resistance. This whole thing is one single node, and this whole thing is one single node. If this is ground, so this is the ground here. And this 4 ohm is also between the same nodes. Then we draw the load resistance. It's called RL. To a home, and this is current IL. Now if you look carefully here, the current here will be how much? This will be some of these two currents. So this will be 6 ampere current here. So we can convert this part into a single current source. This is possible, just like in voltage sources. If voltage sources are in series, we can combine them into one voltage source. Similarly, If current sources are in parallel, we can combine them into one current source. So these two can be combined into 4 plus 2, 6. Ampere current source. And these two also in parallel, because you can draw it like this, with the same node. So basically now they are between two terminals. We've discussed this before. You can only combine resistors if they're between two terminals. So these two 4 ohms in parallel will be equivalent to 2 ohms. Now you can see this 6 ampere current will come here. It will see two paths. This is 2 ohm, this is also 2 ohm. So it will be equally split. So IL will be 3 ampere. So in this case, by converting this voltage source into a current source, it was a voltage source before, we are able to solve this circuit or find the load current very easily. So that's it for this video. I encourage you to watch our other videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.